In this problem, we're going to look at a material balance example that uses a couple different tools in combination with the material balance to analyze a system and set operating conditions for it. So here we have a mixing tank, and it's used to prepare a solution for a reaction. Now the concentration and flow rate of the top stream, stream A, is variable, and we don't know the concentration nor the flow rate of that at a given time, but it's important that we have a specific concentration coming out of the mixing tank for our reactor. So based on the schematic and information below, we need to help an operator determine the appropriate equations to use in the control operations for this process. So where would we see this in a practical application? Maybe we're preparing a solution for a reaction or fermentation in an effort to save costs. Some of the unused reactant is recovered and recycled. So something downstream over here, we're bringing that over back to the start of this process. But we can't just pump it back into the reactor. Maybe it needs filtered, something else needs to be removed. And so we mix it with a fresh stream. So in this case, we're looking at a stream of 50% acetic acid and 50% water. And the goal is to create a solution that's 35% acetic acid and 65% water. So we're going to start with the following problem. Let's just look at the most common setting that this system might experience. So we're given that there's 200 kilograms an hour of solution A is coming into the mixer, and that solution is 15% acetic acid and the rest water. So we want to determine the amount of solution B that we need to add to this mixer to get the resulting outlet flow rate. So we have a material balance problem. Let's start with our general equation. Whatever goes into our mixer minus whatever comes out of our mixer plus anything that's generated or consumed, and we subtract out what's consumed since we're losing it, this must be what's equal to the accumulation within this mixer. So since our control volume is this mixer here, that's what we're looking at. We care about what's coming in and out of that. So we have a very simple mixing tank, no reaction, no accumulation if we assume steady state. So we're left with what goes in equals what comes out. So we have two species, our acetic acid and our water. So we could write two independent material balances. And I'll write an overall balance and a species balance for acetic acid. So our overall balance, we've told that our flow rate is 200 kilograms of A per hour. This is plus the flow rate of B, which is something we're looking for. And what leaves is our stream flow rate of C. For our acetic acid balance, we start with stream A. We're told that we have 15% weight, so I'll write 0.15 kilogram of acetic acid per kilogram of our solution. This is multiplied by our flow rate of 200 kilograms per hour. We do the same for stream B, but here I've multiplied by our unknown flow rate, MB. This is equal to 35% weight times our flow rate of C. So we have two equations. We have two unknowns, MB and MC. So solve using whatever method you like. You should get the resulting equation shown here. And solving for MC, we get 466.7 kilograms per hour. And we get 266.7 kilograms per hour. So does this make sense? Well, we should have a larger flow rate out, and the outlet concentration is closer to solution B, so more of solution B than solution A is likely. So it does pass a common sense check. So we've solved for one set of conditions. Now, if these conditions were changed, we would have to constantly be resolving the material balance on the fly to adjust solution B. If you look at our process, we put in some flow meters and a detector into our streamlines. So based on these flow meter readings and the concentration reading we get for stream A, we could come up with some kind of relationship to dictate how we should control stream B to meet the desired specifications that are leaving. So you purchase some flow meters and you have to calibrate them first with your solutions. The inline detector you add allows instant readings of the composition of A, and this helps determine the weight percent of the acetic acid in the solution. So based on performing the lab calibrations, you get the following values you see here in the table. So your job is first to determine a relationship for the variable of interest, in this case flow rate and composition, as a function of the meter reading, knowing that the flow meters have linear calibration curves, and the detector has a semi-log relationship with concentration on a logarithmic scale, and we're going to use base E, and the reading on the detector is on the linear scale. Now we need to come up with an equation of a line using these points so that we have a relationship between the reading and the actual measurement that we are interested in. So let's start with flow meter on line A. So here I have an equation for a line using a single point that we know of, and we have to fill in the slope using the two points. So using this equation with the measurements we have, I'm going to say that our mass flow rate for stream A minus one of the points, so we'll choose 100, is equal to the slope. This is times our reading on A minus the point value that we used before with the 100 kilograms per hour. So when we solve for our reading as a function of the flow rate, we should get the following. So this says that 0.1 times our mass flow rate plus 25 will give us our reading that we'll see on the flow meter for stream A. So we could repeat this process for the flow meter on stream B. And the result is that the reading on stream B is equal to the following. Now we repeat the same procedure for the detector, but it's important that for the semi-log relationship, we use the log of the value as our y-axis point. So whereas before we had y minus y1, now we have natural log of our composition, x, where x is this weight percent. So the natural log of x minus a point, so natural log we'll choose 10. This is going to be equal to our slope, which is the difference in y points over the difference in x points. And this is times, again, our x reading, so we'll say rx minus the x value that we used with our y value of 10, so that is 4. So now we can solve this relationship for the reading as a function of the composition. So now we have a relationship between our meter readings and the measurement that it's taking. So how can we use this information to help an operator control the flow rate of stream B given information about the incoming stream A? So the goal here is to use the readings on the flow meter of stream A and the detector of stream A to determine what we should set stream B to be based on the flow meter reading of stream B. So we have to determine appropriate ways to combine the equations we have, so the three instruments, as well as the two material balances, to get a relationship for the mass flow rate of B in terms of the composition and flow rate of A. So from a material balance perspective, we have MA, and this is the overall balance, plus MB is equal to MC. So then we can do a species balance for acetic acid. Now we don't know the composition coming in, so I'm going to call this X weight percent of acetic acid times mass flow rate of A. It's important to make sure the units add up, so when we're using the weight percent, to use it appropriately, plus the composition of B, which we know is 0.5, times our mass flow rate of B, and this is equal to what comes out. And this is specified, so 35 weight percent, I'll write it as 0.35, times our mass flow rate of C. So you see we have two equations and four unknowns. So we're not looking for a particular value like we did in the first part of the screencast. Instead, we're trying to come up with a relationship for our flow meter on B. So let's bring in the flow meter relationships. So now we have our two material balances and our three instrument equations. And the goal is to get a final equation that is the reading on flow meter B as a function of the reading on flow meter A and the reading on the detector for A. So we could use our two material balances to cross out MC. We don't really need that. So we'll be left with X, MA, and MB. As you can see, we could get X in terms of RX, which is our reading on the detector, and then we could get A in terms of RA, which is the reading on the flow meter, and then lastly we could substitute our equation for B and rewrite it in terms such that we have RB equals the rest. So I'll set this up just to see what it looks like. So I take our species balance, and I'm going to take X over 100 because again we need it as a fraction to use with our flow rate. So I've used our overall and our species balance to get rid of MC, so we're left with X, MA, and MB. At this point, we could plug in those equations on the left, and you should get one big equation that looks like the following. So I've plugged in all of the equations so that we can solve for RB in terms of RA and RX. And I'll leave that to a good piece of analytical software like Mathematica or MATLAB that you could use to solve for RB. But hopefully you've gotten the point of this exercise and how we could use this in a real life setting to help us control process operations. And in case you didn't think I'd give you the solution I got, this is what I saw after I simplified this expression using Mathematica. So we have our measurement for B as a function of the composition and flow rate on stream A.